Welcome everyone to the love of God. Welcome to Arlington Forest Sunday Worship. I'm Jane Choi, pastor at Arlington Forest. May the Holy Spirit come upon you, give you compassion to serve neighbors during this challenging time. Please join call to worship. Can you hear the voice of God?
We hear God calling us by name.
Are you troubled and distressed?
We come here to find a place to rest for a while.
Come and find a guide who knows these lands.
We come to praise our shepherd and God, whose pathways and doors lead to life.
Amen.
Today's Gospel reading is from the Book of Luke, chapter 10, verses 25 through 37. On one occasion, an expert in the law stood up to test Jesus. "Teacher," he asked, "what must I do to inherit eternal life?" "What is written in the law?" he replied. "How do you read it?" He answered, "Love your Lord God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength and with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself." "You have answered correctly," Jesus replied. "Do this and you will live." But he wanted to justify himself, so he asked Jesus, "And who is my neighbor?" In reply, Jesus said, "A man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho when he was attacked by robbers. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. A priest happened to be going down the same road, and when he saw the man, he passed by on the other side. So too a Levite, when he came to the place and saw him, passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, as he traveled, came where the man was, and when he saw him, he took pity on him. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, pouring on oil and wine. Then he put the man on his own donkey, brought him to an inn, and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii and gave them to the innkeeper. "Look after him," he said, "and when I return, I will reimburse you for any extra expense you may have." Which of these do you think was a neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The expert in the law replied, "The one who had mercy on him." Jesus told him, "Go and do likewise." This is the word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, bless our hearing May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Amen. Who are Christians? Christians are people who accept Jesus Christ as their Savior through baptism and believe in Him. Christians are those who learn Jesus' teachings and actions and want to live like Him. In May, we are going to reflect on Jesus' teachings on Christian living. Jesus' teachings and actions were recorded in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Through the Gospels, you can learn how Jesus wants Christians to live. Christopher Marco wrote a book, The Jesus Priorities, 8 Essential Habits. In this book, he conducted a research on the Gospels about what Jesus consistently said and did in his public ministry. On the basis of the numbers of the events and the recordings, he categorized 8 essential teachings of Jesus. Healing, love, pray, spread the word, build up treasure in heaven, seek God's will, accept children as precious, live with humility. My sermon series in May, Jesus' teachings on Christian living, was inspired by Marco's book, The Jesus Priorities. For the 5 Sundays, we are going to reflect on the teachings of Jesus for Christian living. Compassion, forgiveness, prayer, generosity, witness of Jesus Christ to the world. According to Marco's research, Jesus' healing ministry is the first among all of his ministries. The 4 Gospels recorded 36 events and 63 recordings about Jesus' healing. Jesus' healing ministry started with compassion for the suffering and the poor. There are many stories in the Gospels which demonstrate Jesus' compassion for the sick and the marginalized in society. In the wilderness, Jesus was compassionate for the crowd who were thirsty and hungry. He fed them with 5 loaves and 2 fishes. In Mark's Gospel, there is the story of a boy who suffered from epilepsy and used to throw himself into fire to try to kill himself. Jesus had compassion for the boy and cured him. In today's Bible lesson, Jesus taught us about what compassion is in Christian living. A Jewish man traveled from Jerusalem to Jericho. He was attacked by thieves and left for dead. A priest happened to pass him by, but he ignored him and went on his way. Then a Levite came to the place where the injured man was bleeding. Like the priest, he also hurried to cross over to the other side of the road and disappeared. However, a traveling Samaritan man saw him. He was moved by compassion and took care of him. In the social context, In Jesus' time, Jewish people hated the Samaritans and treated them as unclean because of their religious prejudice. This Good Samaritan man perhaps might have been badly treated by the Jewish people in the past, but he did not care about his painful experience. He simply had compassion for the injured man, regardless of social prejudice. This Good Samaritan saved a Jewish man's life. According to Jesus' teaching, compassion is to treat others with mercy, regardless of how they treat you or what kind of social class they belong to. Jesus' compassion goes beyond our social prejudice. He does not care about legal or illegal immigrants. He does not care about gay or straight. He does not care about your ethnicity. Jesus cares about those who suffer, regardless. Mother Teresa, founder of Missionaries of Charity, is one who practiced Jesus' compassion very well. Her community served the poorest of the poor around the world, beyond race, nationality, or religion. In the process of the formation of the nuns in her community, she focused on developing their love for Christ and suffering neighbors. She told them to go out and find Jesus in their neighbor and serve him in the poor. Let me share a story of Mother Teresa which happened in Australia. When she opened the house of the Missionaries of Charity in Melbourne, she and her sisters went around the area stricken by poverty. One day, she went to a small house and found an old man neglected and surrounded by filth. She asked him to allow her to clean his house, wash his clothes, and make his bed. But he said to her, "Don't bother me, I'm all right." She said to him again, "You'll feel better if you allow me to clean everything above it." "Well, if you want, you can," he answered. Mother Teresa cleaned and washed everything. Then, in the corner of the room, she saw a beautiful lamp covered with dust and filth. Mother Teresa asked, "Do you light this lamp in the evening?" He looked at her and said, "For whom? For years and years, nobody has come to see me. Would you light the lamp if my sisters come to see you?" "Yes, of course," he said with a smile. Mother Teresa cleaned the lamp and left it sparkling. The sisters started visiting him every evening. He lit the lamp for them. Since then, Mother Teresa forgot completely about She received a message from this old man through the sisters in Australia. Tell my friend the light she has lit in my life is burning. It is still burning. Jesus' compassion comes from genuine love for those who suffer, regardless of who they are or what they belong to. Even a little bit of genuine love has the power to transform people's lives and the world. The stories of the Good Samaritan and Mother Teresa prove the transforming power of compassion and love. During this COVID-19 pandemic, many people have lost their jobs. They are having a hard time even buying food. The Arlington Food Assistance Center has overwhelming demands from our neighbors. They urgently need canned food, such as vegetables, soups, tuna, and tomato products. They have been providing uniformed bags of food for pre-pickups and deliveries for families in need. We are helping some neighbors with grocery gift cards from the pastor's discretionary fund whenever they call us. I encourage you to extend compassion ministry for Arlington neighbors. Arlington Food Assistance Center pray for receiving checks rather than food, since they do not have enough volunteers to sort and bag it. If you are able, please write checks to the church indicating PDF-AFAC in the memo of your check. A little light of compassion and love saves people's lives and gives hope for the future. Amen.
Thank you.
May the love of God, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Serve your neighbors with compassion. Amen.